What's going on, Word Wizards? Mr. Primich here, looking to build your vocabulary, because when your vocabulary is strong, it helps your reading, it helps your writing, and it makes you sound more intelligent when you speak and you can understand more. Such an important thing to do, so let's get into it. Pause the video here and see if any of these words or images look familiar to you. All right, let's get into it. Starting off with our first word here, it is a noun and it's coincidence. Now, coincidence is when a situation happens where things are happen at the same time or without planning. Word, a similarity, an accident, parallelism. Remember parallel from geometry, where we talk about two lines that are going in the same direction. A coincidence is essentially when something happens that is the exact same as something else, or a coincidence might be that you wanted something for your birthday, like a new pair of shorts, and you got them right before your birthday, or that someone wears the same clothes, like in our example here. It was a coincidence that my mom wore the exact same shirt as her boss. They didn't plan it, it just happened to be the same. So that's our first word, coincidence. Moving into our next word, consequences. This is a plural noun. A consequence is the result of what happens when you make a choice. So typically consequences are associated with bad things, but a consequence can be a good thing too. But usually when consequence is used in the English language, it's an effect or a follow-up for a poor choice that you made. So we talk about like when you're a little kid, if you go to timeout, it's a consequence of making a poor choice. So word web words that go with consequences are effect, follow-up, result, reaction, or fallout. And our sentence that goes along with consequences are, she suffered the consequences of not tying her shoe when she tripped on the stairs. So because she didn't take the time to tie her shoe before she walked down the stairs, she had consequences for it. It's basically, if you think of cause and effect, we talk about that a lot in school, effect is a consequence. Our next word that we're looking at is our verb, and it is consume. Consume means to eat up something or to destroy. So when we talk about consume, you can consume food, a car can consume gas, a fire might consume a forest, but consume means to eat up, destroy, take care of, get rid of. So our word web words, these are other verbs that are like consume, are eat, destroy, devour, finish, or use. And our sentence that goes along with the word consume is, I consumed my whole sandwich for lunch today, meaning that you ate or you used up the whole sandwich. Our next word is an adjective, and it is converted. Now, convert is a verb, which means to change or to alter. When we add ed, we can either make a verb past tense or we can turn it into an adjective to change its meaning. So converted in this case is an adjective, which means when something is changed from its original form or purpose. Word web words that go along with converted are changed, transformed, reformed, improved, or altered. So our sentence that goes along with our picture is, my neighbors converted an old school bus into a tiny house. So as you can see in the picture there, there's a cool school bus. You can still see the front with the tires, but they have converted it. They've changed it, they've altered it, and they've now turned it into a teeny tiny little cabin, which is pretty cool, converted. Our next word is efficient. Efficient is an adjective, and it's an easy or more effective way to do a job. When something is efficient, you figure out a way to do more and use less energy. So word web words that go with this are easy, effective, useful, helpful, handy, and our sentence that goes along with the word efficient is, using a ramp and wheelbarrow is an efficient way to get the rocks into the truck. So it's easier than picking the rocks up and throwing them in. Using the ramp and the wheelbarrow, you can carry more rocks. It doesn't use as much of your energy. So that's what efficient means. Efficient means being able to do more with less. Hint is a verb. You might have heard of hint as a noun, like give me a hint, give me a hint. So you probably heard of that content before, and the verb is not that different. Hint the verb means to share a message secretly or in an indirect way. So you might think of hint as suggest, mention, remain, inform, or ask. Those are our word web words that go along with the word hint. In our sentences, my dog Charlie hinted to us that he was very hungry. So of course dogs can't talk, but a hint means that you're not directly saying something, but more you're trying to get the person to guess what you're saying. So if you want something for your birthday, you might hint to your parents that you might need something. For example, If you were hoping to get some new sneakers for your birthday, you might hint that you need some new sneakers by saying, oh boy, look at all the holes in my shoe. Sure do wish I could get some new sneakers. And that would be an example of how you would hint at something. Our next word here is incredible. I bet you've heard of this word before. Incredible is an adjective that means too extraordinary or unlikely to believe. So if we look at the word, it's got the word credible in it. And credible, if you're credible, it means you're reliable or you're believable. So like a credible source when you're doing research is something that you can believe. In is a prefix meaning not. So the literal definition of incredible is it's like not believable or you can't believe it. But we use incredible typically as a positive. And we say something's really incredible is that it's awesome. So let's take a look at our word web words. Extraordinary, which is an old vocabulary word. Unbelievable, amazing, improbable, or crazy. So there's our picture there. If you can see that incredible bicycle kick. Cristiano scored an incredible goal this Saturday. I've never seen anything like it. So it means it's wonderful to a point where you can't even believe it. Our next word here is install. It is a verb which means to set up, put in, or prepare to use. And as you can see, set up and put in are there in our word web, but you can also say prepare, fix, or position are other words that you can use alongside of install. And our sentence that goes with install is Olivia and her husband Greg installed a new window. They put in a new window. That's what it means to install something. You get something new and you put it in. We install software into our computers all the time. It asks for updates and it will ask you to install programs or apps into our phones, tablets, or computers. So install means to put in or to set up something. Our next word is lack. Lack is a verb meaning to not have enough of or to be missing something. So words that go along with lack are need, require, want, miss, or to be without. An opposite or an antonym for the word lack would be have. So think of, if you think of lack, it means that you don't have something, and have is the antonym, having something. So our sentence that goes along with the word lack is the car lacked gas to get to the store, so we have to stop and fill up the tank. So lack means you don't have something once again. Coming into our final three words here, we've got another adjective, practical. Practical's definition is that something that is easy to use and that makes sense. Sensible, functional, useful, handy, and constructive are all synonyms or words in that word web of practical. Also, if you think of the word efficient from earlier in this lesson, efficient is kind of slightly a synonym of the word practical in that, you know, it just makes something easier or makes sense. So our sentence that goes along with practical is the umbrella was a practical thing to bring on our walk on this rainy day. It means made sense. It was a good idea. Renewable, we've got an adjective here. A lot of word parts in this word. New, you guys all know what new means. Able means it's capable or able to. So, and then re means again. So if you renew something, you make it new again. So like if you renew a book from the library, you get the book again. So able there at the end of it means that it's capable of being renewed. So our definition is when something can be renewed, restored, or used again and again. Word web verbs that go with this are sustainable, endless, continual, limitless. And our sentence is wind is a renewable resource since we can use it without it running out. So again, water is not, if you pollute water or you ruin water, it's not necessarily something you can use again and again and again. It should. With our water cycle, but not necessarily. Oil is not renewable because once you use up oil, you can't use it again. So wind is renewable. It just will come and it will become new over and over again. You don't have to make wind. So that's our picture if you're not quite sure. Those are wind turbines and they spin and they create energy. So when we talk about wind being a renewable resource, that's what they mean. You don't have to create wind. If you use wind, it's not gone forever. It'll return again. That's what renewable means. And then our last word here is a verb, and it's very. Now, it's not V-E-R-Y like a lot. This is V-A-R-Y, very, like different. So when you vary something, you make a change or you make it be different. When we talk about vary, word web words, differ, modify, change, fluctuate, and alter, those are all words that can be used interchangeably with the word very. And our sentence that goes along with it is, even though it was sunny a minute ago, the weather varied, so now it's rainy. So those are our words, ladies and gentlemen. Keep working at them. Practice them all week. good luck with your quiz, and I am very proud of your vocabulary brain growing.